Hi everyone, this is Stephanie for IVA, the Institute for Vocal Advancement. Welcome to our health and wellness series for voice teachers. So today I will be talking about creating a comfortable studio environment. What does that have to do with your health and well-being? Well, actually a lot, because what you're surrounding yourself with in terms of environment, no matter if it's at your workplace or at home, that has a lot to do with how you're feeling and how well you are. So since we're spending so much time at our studios, it's definitely worth thinking about this aspect of our well-being, okay? So what are things to think about in terms of making your workplace, making your studio more comfortable and possibly more cozy? Well, first, let's talk about furniture, okay? The furniture that you're sitting on, your chair. I highly recommend for you, because I know that some of you might be like sitting on a plastic folding chair, which is a cheap thing to do and it's fairly easy to move. At the same time, you want to make sure that you're sitting in a chair that is somewhat ergonomic, okay? And that even when you're sitting there for a couple of hours, doesn't give you a back pain. Something that possibly can turn and move, maybe even with armrests, so sometimes you can sit back, rest your arms when you're listening to your student singing a song, okay? What else? The chair needs to be able to be elevated or lowered so you can adjust it depending on what you're currently working on and the position of the piano, okay? So let's keep talking about the piano. The one thing is you need to make sure it's high or low enough so your arm can be put into a nice angle and you don't have your hands too high or too low, which has a big impact on your neck. You know, sometimes if you're like getting a neck ache after a couple of hours of teaching, it might have to do with your chair or the position of your piano. So you want to check that, okay? Also, in terms of piano, you know, make sure your piano has, if you're working on a keyboard, it has weighted keys, because if it doesn't have weighted keys, it can be very hard on your hands and on your joints, okay? And also the sound is kind of like not the nicest, which also has an impact on you feeling well playing the piano, right? Other than that, make sure if you're playing on an electric piano, that it is not wiggly when you're playing on it, okay? So it doesn't move too much. So you want to make sure that it has a really nice and solid stand that it's on. So next, let's talk about the seating for your students. While here, most of the time students probably are going to stand while they're singing. So it seems like for those phases of the lessons when they're actually sitting, a folding chair might be enough. But you really want to think about maybe investing into one or two nicer, more comfortable chairs for your students, okay? Because on the one hand, it looks better, it makes them feel better, and you know, whenever your student feels good about something when they come to you, of course, except for your brilliant lessons that you're teaching, but if they're feeling comfortable at your studio, guess what? That makes you feel better, okay? Maybe if you even want to put a couch and a coffee table into it that looks really nice and cozy and makes everybody feel great when at your studio. So now let's talk about the walls. Are the walls of your studio nice, white, and clean? That is great. But you might want to think about color. Okay, because color has a huge impact on your mood. So that doesn't mean that you need to paint the whole room, but maybe one wall or even just part of a wall. Or like if you have a pillar in your in your studio, maybe you want to paint that. It's a really nice, beautiful touch that refreshes the atmosphere in the room quite a lot. So you want to think about a picture or two on the wall. You know, maybe something that really resonates with you and that makes you feel good when you're looking at it, okay? Maybe even some like visual anatomical charts about the voice that you can put on the wall. That's great for your students to look at, maybe even for you to explain things. And it makes just the whole environment even more professional. And that makes you feel good, okay? So what else? Smell, very important. So for once, you definitely want to make sure that you get some fresh air into your studio, possibly after every student, you know, so when you're, before your next student comes in, open the window, open the door, get some nice fresh air in. But in addition to that, you might want to think about maybe like an incense candle that you can even light during the colder months of the year, or you know, maybe some very, very light room refresher. You know, I have this very light lavender spray that I sometimes use if I feel like it, and it gives this really nice, fresh, but very decent smell in the studio that I really, really appreciate. What I don't recommend are incense sticks, you know, those ones that you light and then they're kind of like burning down. Those can really be very irritating to your students' voices, and they're not making the air the freshest. So you might wanna not do those. What's also very nice in terms of smell are fresh flowers. They smell good, they look beautiful, and are just really refreshing the atmosphere in your studio. Also in terms of plants, besides fresh flowers, if you have natural light at your studio, you might want to think about a nice plant, okay? That gives a great atmosphere at your studio. If you don't have natural light at your studio, think about a fake plant, you know? So I actually have two fake palm trees at my studio. They look pretty real, and I love them. They make a great addition to my studio, okay? And last but not least, you want to think about seasonal decoration at your studio. You know, just like for Christmas, during springtime or Easter, just little things at your studio that just make the studio cozy and nice, and when your students come in and they see something new, it just delights their heart, you know? So, and I just would like for your studio to be a place for you where you feel cozy and at home, you know? So it really makes you feel good when you're spending time there and when you're going there. So I hope you find that helpful. I hope that this gives you some inspiration in terms of creating a beautiful environment at your workplace. So please stay in touch, give us some feedback, click the bell below so you get notified for more of these series, and keep in touch, okay? Be well, all the best.